Why should we do it? Because we can, and I'm a good cook, Alan's a good painter. No one's ever tried to combine and cooking and painting together.
We've got a nice container with fresh, clean water, brushes, some watercolour paints. We're going to do mozzarella, buffalo mozzarella, and we're going to wrap this in our prosciutto, and we place this in the oven.
Because we both spend time in Italy with work, that's where we're going to go. Philip's going to be going around the markets getting ingredients which he's going to cook on location, and whilst he's doing that, I'll be painting some kind of famous view, landmark, and going through the actual process of painting.
Okay, what we've got here is the Launceston Place Restaurant here in Kensington. It's quite early morning, but the light's kind of dancing and shimmering a little bit. You've got people passing.
You know, not just the landscapes, but the fish markets, the painting the boats, the fishmongers. I'm going to cook the local produce, and yeah, I'll give you the correct recipes from that region.
So we're cutting these courgettes, 3 millimetres thickness. Place them into the mixing bowl. Drizzle it with some olive oil, some salt, some pepper. Get nicely coated. Lay it on the char griller.
The pencil marks that I'm making are really just very simple indications. I want a certain amount of spontaneity to come through with the actual brush marks that I make, so I don't want to be restricted by too many pencil lines. Now I'm excited because now I've got to get some colour down. All right. This is the daunting part for many beginners and people that are inexperienced. It's like you've got a nice clean sheet of white paper and you dare to put some colour on. Just a little bit lighter patch there where the sun was breaking through. Initially you think, oh, this yellow is far too strong, it's going to dominate. But really, when you get the other colours on top, you might even wonder, I could have gone a bit even brighter.
And then here I've got a dressing of mustard, lemon and olive oil. I'll put these lovely cherry tomatoes on. Okay, we lay the courgettes. Now they're nice and char grilled, as you can see. And you've got the colours of Italy. You've got the green, the yellow and the red. All waiting for now is a main star, mozzarella wrapped in prosciutto. Nice and crispy. It's in here. There we go. Nice and soft in the centre. Crispy on the outside. And there we have it. Our mozzarella wrapped in prosciutto with cherry tomatoes, courgettes and balsamic reduction.
If I remember rightly, there's a little bit of cloud coming up here. You've really only got an instant to sort of get it, and if it's knacked, then that's it, you've had it. So, I'm not really happy with that shape. Let's take that out. This is what I love about watercolour, is that you just don't know how it's going to end up. Oops, I've gone and botched that. I think what'll excite people is when they actually come to look at Philip cooking, or they're watching me painting, is the whole thing of, well, I can do this. I'd like to have a go at this. If they can do it, then we could have a go at it. And it's just breaking down all the kind of the mystique about cooking and painting and keeping it on a very simple, straightforward level.
And the main course now, we've got the Dover sole with our shrimp, cucumber and dill dressing. Brown shrimps from Morecambe on the west coast of England. We just put them into the little bowl here, small cup of them. And the cucumber. And next, we're going to use that lovely fragrant herb, dill. Just roughly chop that. One lemon, juice off. Give that a good squeeze. Half a cup of olive oil. Extra virgin oil, this is the best one you can get. And just mix that together. And there you have a lovely light, refreshing dressing to go with your Dover sole.
We're not in your face. We're not going to be shouting and waving our hands about. We're just like two brothers down to earth who are very good at what we do.
You see how the actual texture of the paper captures and gives indications and the feeling of lots of leaves. The whole thing's quite lively. Don't want to get too fiddly doing every little leaf. I love working on a nice, coarse, handmade paper because it's got a lot of texture and a lot of bite. Just a few leaves just flicked in there. But again, not getting too niggly, not getting too detailed. Keeping it light, keeping it fresh. And then that's it, I don't want to do any more to that.
Wee bit of light oil there. Take our Dover soles, season that, salt and pepper. Dip that into flour so it doesn't stick. Place into our pan.
Yeah, this is the bit that's really going to help to sort of pull the painting around. these darks which are going to really kind of throw the Launceston into the foreground. It immediately becomes the main point of interest. And then I'm just going to throw in a few kind of darks in that reflection. See what we'll come up with. Just to kind of indicate as though there could be things behind the glass.
We'll check our vegetables. They're nearly ready. I'll flip them over. They're going to take 2 minutes on the other side and they'll be perfect.
You don't have to put everything in just because it's there. I mean, there could be a dog dump lying on the ground. I mean, that wouldn't add to the painting at all. So you've got the freedom as the artist to leave out things, to put things in. That's called artist license.
Taking our Dover sole. Just lay them up nicely on the vegetables.
The other secret about watercolour painting is you've got to know when to stop. Quite honestly, I don't really want to do any more to this. So all that remains to be done now is to gently sign it.
So that's it. Finito.
And here for the dressing, we've got a shrimp, cucumber and dill dressing. Just lay over the top of that liberally and then around the outside like so.
I'm very calm and low-key, understated. And Philip's more exuberant. He's more volatile, I think.
Volatile?
That's not necessarily.
Do I have to put something?
No, no. Volatile is the wrong word. He's more kind of. What's it?
Well, what's the first I am? I'm honest, sincere, lovely, charming. You know, all these things.
Philip's more the joker. My sense of humour is probably a little bit drier.
Yeah, he won't get it until 2 weeks.
He won't get it until the following week.
If you get it at all.